The cake of ice in the background there has been grounded there for must be a couple of months now. Of course, a lot of these other ones are grounded too. But it'll probably float out when the tide comes up. Just beyond, you can see, probably in the center there, where it's more clearly, is where the bank is cut down. This will allow them to build the wharf area and to be able to take the bridge supports out. Just this side of that pile of gravel, you may be able to notice where the bank is cut down. Now, just this way, probably halfway through that cut, which we will see a little closer later on, is where the wharf is going to be. And this wharf will be extending out quite a piece. I understand that the tug, or rather this crane, the wharf will be built out from that low part of the bank out to quite a piece where the crane will come in to the end of the wharf, and these bridge supports will be taken out and placed with the crane. The ice is quite loose these days, but there's still lots of it to come down yet. A lot of these cakes of ice you see are grounded. About halfway down between here and just where the bank starts being the bank again is where the pier is going to be built for taking the farms out to the bridge site. The bridge site, incidentally, is more or less behind the oil tanks. Let's go over there again. This gravel, I believe, is destined to be used in that cement plant. You just see the top in the background there. This will be used for building the pier. Thank you.
This is the new wharf that they're building, or jetty. A few days ago, they unloaded some, well, I guess you call it coarse sand, which I believe came from Porcupine over Nova Scotia. I missed taking the photograph of it, or at least taking a video of it. Perhaps the next time it's down, I'll get one. It was very long. It seemed to run from the jetty to approximately in the area where that scow is now, or barge. They're driving piles out there now to build a more permanent. Now, in this boat, they're taking soundings, I would take it. Joey is amongst one of them. Of course, from this distance, you could never make out who they are. But I saw him coming to work there about half an hour ago perhaps, and heading down towards the site here. And shortly after, I saw this boat going out. It's a little green dory. This is one of the dredges, I would say. It has a crane on it anyway. I imagine they'll be using it on the other side where the approaches are going to be. I'll go over to where the bridge area is being built, and you can see another one. I don't believe it is doing anything right there, but the area where the bridge is going to be is just beyond that and up by the oil tanks, which you can't see from here. Just on the other side of CN Marine oil tanks, that's where the bridge approaches will be built. Most of that gravel that's down there, especially the light colored one, I believe came from Porcupine. Well, that may be incorrect. Perhaps it's the one to our right. It looks like four little mountains there. I believe that was the one that may have came, because I think those other ones were there before. Anyway, that barge was big. Just behind the barn is the new administration building. I guess that's what they call it. I believe all the engineers and whatnot will be in there. I think it'll be ready for occupancy in about probably a week. And of course, this is my house. There used to be a good number of trees along here. This is all that's left of one of them. Just the roots. I don't know just how that got pulled out. I guess probably just pulled out of the time and just blew down. Like a lot of the trees here, just blew down in the wind. And it just ended up that way. I don't know where the rest of it is. Perhaps parts of it are over here. Back again on my own side of the fence. I'm not sure if they're going to make this burn any higher or not. They seem to be working at it a bit off and on. At one time it was too high, they thought. Took it down a bit. Then they added more to it. Maybe with this as a windbreak, I might get a chance to grow some trees along there, along that fence. This property actually belongs to Maritime Electric, on the other side of the fence. Some old buildings I have to take down pretty soon. Thought at one time I might do something with one of them. And that pile of garbage, is going to burn it, but now I don't know. They said they'd take it away from me. Perhaps I'll make them hold them to their word. This is one of the first few fine days we've had. Yesterday was a nice day, but today is much nicer. see somebody working out up there on McNamara's area. Another building which I must do something with. So I might make a hothouse out of it. It used to be an area where they kept meat and stuff for the foxes. I believe they used ice that they kept in an ice house that was nearby. I'd like to restore it to something, but the way it is now looks pretty dilapidated, pretty sick. I believe these are the area, this is the area where they're building some of the bridge spans. Thank you.
for the sound?
Yeah, I want it off.
Is the blue cold?
Oh no, it's still colder than the rest. It's just that there's more clay in here, mud. Oh, we'll go, what, mean home, 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 or up there?
Like, our home.
Oh, whenever you want to go.
Oh, good. Will you play chess with me?
Well, we'll see. Now, I got a lot of things to do.
To play chess, then do the stuff.
No, first we're eating. Okay. And then we're going swimming. And then, what else?
This shows them placing one of the cribs in place. Unfortunately, I was a little too late getting down to see the whole thing. I guess they're using the dredge there to steady it as they put it in position. Thank you.
There was so much dust that blew up off the fields a few days ago that the trees were literally red. Now we've had a rain since then, and a lot of it has washed off. Still plenty red. I believe this is supposed to be the largest crane they're going to have. Wind blowing today. Blown, even though it's blowing fairly hard, the temperature is about 80. Still very humid. Thank you. This is Milligan's Wharf up Handy Freeland. Georgie and I are up here visiting Gene Tupman. Just this side of the sand hills, and to the left, is the water area which leads to Hardy's Channel. A tuna boat. Here we are at Gene Tupman's house.
Between LED and the Western World, that's happening. On the right. And you could say that this is me, you know, looking for a subject.
Okay, then go ahead. Go ahead.
Is it a movie camera that you...
Yeah, a camcorder, yeah.
Mm-hmm. A lot of the brush there doesn't tip over it now.
I bet it.
Donald had cleaned out under here the trees and he didn't take the things away.
Mm-hmm.
And the young fella came with a machine and cut them up. Wonderful lady, isn't he, for years? She likes the view up the creek there, the little boat.
That's beautiful.
This is nice.
I really thought of paint that.
Well, I'm glad to hear that now.
This tree is covered with quite a bit of ice. Now, in a bigger tree, with the wind blowing like this, it has a great tendency to break the branches. Maybe a few small branches in this tree will get broken. But the really nice is not that thick. This is an example of a branch that's bent down quite a bit. Still, I don't think there's enough ice on it to break it. Too bad the sun is not shining. It's a lot more dramatic looking at the ice crystals. There hasn't been much ice this year, but the ice has wrapped it up down on the shore simply because there hasn't been that much ice and the wind was able to shove it in. There's quite a bit of open water, but the ice has still wrapped it up over there, Bill's head. This is one of these snowstorms that we can get in April. The snow is quite heavy on the trees, but unfortunately the wind has come up. I'm in a sheltered area right now. Give you an idea how much snow there was on it. It is starting to drift, as one can see. The snow when it came down earlier was a big flake. Quite beautiful, really. The snow can be very beautiful, but at the same time, treacherous. Today the bridge is shrouded in snow showers and fog. This is certainly not typical for this time of year. As you can see, there isn't any snow. The temperature right now is, probably about -7 or -8. It's colder than it has been for the past number of days. There, you can see a little bit of ice in the ditch there. Now, normally this time of year, there'd be almost a mountain of snow, but of course the last few years we haven't had much snow anyway, but this certainly is an exception. A few days ago, there was open water. In fact, there is a bit of a ridge of it there now. Depending which way the wind blows. But it was totally open there about 3 weeks ago or 2 weeks ago. These narcissus that are poking up have no business coming up this time of year, although they're in pretty well in a warm area up the yard by the foundation. They get the afternoon sun. It is now noon, really. The yard is pretty dead to what it was a few years ago. There's not much left here after the bustle of construction there a number of years ago. Of course, there's still some of the cement pillars still standing, quite a few of them, in fact. A few days ago, when this was mild weather, that was just all water. It has since frozen. Temperature right now is about -8, about 2:30 in the afternoon. One of the gantry cranes there. I believe one of them has left some time ago. I think a couple of years ago it took it out on a barge. Thank you.
This is one of the many barges of crushed rock that has been hauled here. And they unload it here, of course, and move it up to these piles. This gravel is, or rather crushed rock, is used for the actual cement. The gravel that they use for piling on the, around the site to keep the dust down and to work on, keep the mud out, is that large pile that we've seen earlier. There's a couple of their trucks on the jetty, which we'll be loading shortly. There's one of them right there. That, I believe, is the vacation land, of course, going by the Edgewood, which has already been docked. That's one of the big rigs that they're using for doing some work for the actual bridge approach itself. Thank you.
see now that the tug has got the barge very well in position. Strange that they don't have one of the other tugs pushing it in though.